Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So in the last video we have discussed about two questions from the GATE exam, and I have given you with the help of reference that the answers which are given in the GATE answer key are correct. And in that video itself I have discussed that this question in the GATE aptitude part, okay, in the general aptitude part, this particular question was I just asked for some time so that I can just look upon this, and I have searched about this particular question also. There is one more question about that nickel complex and the electronic spectra of that. So I'll try to explain these two questions in this particular video, right? So we'll first of all talk about this one, where it says that select the word that fits the analogy, okay? So white is given as whitening, then light is equals to what? Now in the last video I said that it should be lighting. I was also expecting the same, but when I went through the dictionaries, right, I have referred to Oxford Learner Dictionary. So if you refer that particular dictionary, I'll show what is the meaning of these words. So light, we all know, right? So lightening, the meaning of the word lighten, which is a verb, and the transitive form of that verb. Okay, transitive means when that verb is applied on a particular object directly. Okay, and then it makes sense. So that is called as transitive verb. So yeah, transitive form of this is to lighten something or to reduce the amount of work, depth, worry, etc. So this actually, this meaning we don't need over here because we are not talking about from this aspect, right? So there are two sense of this word. So lightening, so don't get confused with the word lighten over here, okay? It's a verb, and lightening means it will be the other like form of this, right? So that will be the present participle form of that. So lightening, the other transitive meaning of that is to become or to make something become brighter or lighter in color, okay? So that means to make something become brighter or lighter in color. That's what the meaning of lightening we can take, okay? So the word are also taken over here. Now similarly, whitening, for whitening if you search in the same dictionary, so you will find out that whitening means again the same. It means to become white or whiter, or to make something white or whiter. Understood? So both of these, like lightening means making something lighter or brighter, whereas whitening means making something whiter or whiter. Okay, white or whiter. So both of these things make sense. Now I also searched for lighting. Okay, the one which we were discussing. So what does this lighting means? So lighting basically is used, or basically it is used, or it is used to express the arrangement of type of light, that what kind of light it is, whether it is natural lighting or electric lighting, or it is a good lighting or poor lighting. So it tells you about the arrangement or the type of light in that particular place. The other use is to use the use of electric light in a place. Okay, so yeah, so these are the other uses of it. Okay, and there are many examples of this, but this meaning does not make sense with the analogy, right? So if white is whitening, which means that to become white or whiter, or to make something white or whiter. So in the same way, lightening also means to make something bright or lighter in the color. Okay, so that's how I think that's how we got it. Okay, so I think the answer which is given in the answer key, which is given lightening, is the correct answer for this particular question. So this is what I think. Okay, I have searched, and there are many other dictionaries. They are giving different meanings. You can also look upon it in the way that which word is noun, which is verb. But I think this makes much sense. Okay, you can if you are searching for the meaning, and if you want really to search it, I will suggest you to find out the meaning of both lightening and to find out the meaning of lighting, okay? And then just check that which supports the better explanation, or which supports the better analogy, right? So just try to do that. Lightening, we don't have to worry about those. So I think the option is correct in the GATE answer key. That should be option number B, okay? Talking about one more question which some of you have asked me in the comment section of the previous video, so I'll try to explain that as well. Okay, let me just search that question up. Yeah, so here is the question number 34. It says that the electronic absorption spectra of an aqueous solution of NiNH3+6+2+ a weak band is observed between the bands due to transition of 3A2G to 3T2G, then 3A2G to 3T1GF. The transition responsible for the weak band is, okay, so what is where you will get that weak band from? Now, to answer this particular thing, I have tried to search a lot of research papers from here. So direct example I could not find, but yeah, I have found nickel in +2 oxidation state, and it's in a research paper over here. It says, why does middle band in the absorption spectrum of NiH2O6+? Okay, so it's a complex with aqua as a ligand or water as the ligand. Here also nickel is in +2 oxidation state, and it is shown that it has 2 maxima in between. Okay, so if you look upon the absorption maxima, here it's given that the transition happens from 3A2G to 3T1GF, and also from 3A2G to it's given comma, right? So that means these two peaks, the one over here, it is because of 3A2G to 3T1GF, and the other one is because of 3A2G to 1E1G. 1EG, okay, that's because of 1EG. Now, this is what is given to you. If you just Google search it, you can find out a lot of images regarding the same. There are although they are not from these are all from SlideShare, and you'll mostly find it from SlideShare. All of them suggest to the same thing, that there is a transition happening. All of them are nickel in +2 oxidation state, okay, and we can with a weak fielding end. So it's from A2G to E1G. And if you look upon this particular research paper, they have explained it with the help of Tanabe-Sugano diagram. So there it has been explained that how that transition will take place. Now you can see from 3A2G, it will go to 3T1G. It will also go to 1E1G, and it can also go to 3T1G. Okay, so it can go, the transitions can be seen like this. This transition is weak transition because the spin multiplicity is changing. Okay. So spin forbidden and Laporte forbidden, both forbidden it is. So that's why I think the answer should be E1G. I'll try to explain you as well. So let me just try to show you. So this image I have just taken from the Google search which I got. So here you can see that this is a weak band which is shown. Okay, that is from 3A2G to 1E1G. Now how you will get this particular band? So we have nickel in +2 oxidation state, right? So so we have nickel in +2 oxidation state, and that means it's a D8 complex. D8 complex, if you write down in the ground state, so octahedral D8 complex will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So the Mulliken term given for this will be A2G, right? And since the multiplicity, since 2 unpaired electrons, so multiplicity will come out to be 3. Now after making the transition, it can make transitions in this way. So it can undergo one spin allowed transition, and it can form something like this. Okay, so the Mulliken term, since both of these electronic states, this is T2G and EG, both are asymmetrically filled, so this one will be called as T2G. Okay, so the state, this particular state will be called as T2G, and since we have three and 2 unpaired electrons, so 3 will be the spin multiplicity. Now you can also have one more state, cited state, in which the transition will happen from your so the transition which you can see over here will be in such a way that you will be having so here it will be, this will be T1G, okay, and it will be also 3. Now these are all spin allowed transitions, okay, so that's why they will be sharp. In order to get a weak, because in the question it's given that it's a weak band, so what has happened that this particular one over here, the electrons in the EG state, they can pair them, they can get paired up because of higher pairing energy, okay, and what will happen that they will pair up with each other, and they will form a low spin complex. So that low spin complex will be generated in this particular case, and it will be something like this. Okay, so here the Mulliken term will be EG, and the spin multiplicity will come out 1. So this is a state which will get generated if it is low spin complex. Now although you will see that, okay, fine, you will say that the given state over here is a nickel complex, and it's a high spin complex, right? It will not form low spin complex, But the reason is, like, it is also a possible state, right? This energy state is possible. The possibility of this energy state is there. So that's why this band we are getting, but it's a weak band. There are two reasons. First is that although it's a weak field ligand, okay, so that's why this particular transition is not that much favorable. Secondly, the spin multiplicity is getting changed, so that's why also like the band is a weaker band. Okay, so the band becomes weak because of the spin like spin forbidden transition as well as Laporte forbidden transition. Okay, now if you come back to that particular question which was there in the gate exam, if you see, so here that is from 3A2G to 1E1G. If you look upon the other transitions over there, if you see, in all of them the spin multiplicity is getting changed in all the options, right? So that means you have to generate a T1G state with one spin multiplicity. That is not going to happen in any of their form. Okay, that's what I have just shown you with the help of that spin, like with the help of that electronic transitions. If you do the electronic transition to get T1G or T2G like energy states, in that particular case your spin multiplicity will remain 3. It will not become 1. Okay, you know, when it will become 1, spin multiplicity will become 1 only if that state has a EG Mulliken term. So that means this is the only state which is possible. Also, your Tanabe-Sugano diagram is also helping you to identify that, right? So in the Tanabe-Sugano, you can see that the transition is from 3A2G to E1G. So I think that is much clearer now. And those who are having doubt in this particular question, I think you guys understood it well. Okay, so option number third is correct option, and it's given correctly in the gate answer key. So these were two questions which I found that they needed to be explained because there were a lot of discussions. One more question is there in the number of diastereomers. I don't think that is needed to be explained because that's quite simple. Okay, you are just missing up something. Okay, so you just try to do it properly, you will get the correct answer. So the answer given in the gate answer key is correct. For as per as I know, all the answers which are given in the gate answer key are correct as per what I know right now. Okay, so I hope this is much clearer, and I hope you guys understood it well. If you guys have any doubt, you want to ask anything, you can ask me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Till then, have a great day. Bye bye.